Unfortunately, one person was yesterday killed while several others sustained various injuries in an attack on a church in Katia local government area of Kaduna State. The gunman was said to have attacked worshippers during a Sunday morning service. In a similar vein, one person was also killed by a gunman in Kamacha community. The Commissioner for Internal Security and Home Affairs, Samuel Arwan, who confirmed both incidents, said security agencies reported the attack to the state government, noting that the injured worshippers were taken to the hospital. He said the attack was condemned by the governor, Nasser El-Rufai. Well, joining us to discuss this is Joseph Hayab. He's the Secretary General for the Christian Association of Nigeria, CAN, in Kaduna State. Reverend Hayab, I do not know if I can say it's really good to see you, or it's, well, it's on a sour note that we have to say good evening to each other.
Thank you very much. I'm actually the chairman of CAN Kaduna State.
Okay.
So that our viewers will know the difference, so that tomorrow they won't assume
apologies,
we are changing.
Apologies for
no problem.
Well, so I'm almost at a loss for words when we have to have these conversations, because I think we're having too many of them. You know, almost every month we have to have a conversation on Kaduna State. And recently the state was having an event of sorts, which is asking for people to come and invest in Kaduna State. But then we're seeing many more cases of insecurity in Kaduna State. And I'm wondering, is this not a bad picture that we're, or bad advertisement of sorts that we're sending to people who were asking to invest in the state? And it's not just about banditry. We're having all forms of insecurity, and now it's going into places of worship. As the Christian Association of Nigeria, I know that you're not the government. You may not be able to have answers to all my questions, but what advocacies are you pushing for security, not just for schools, that you can also have in your places of worship, and not just in churches, but also in mosques?
Well, thank you very much for having me on this program. And thank you for your show of concern about what is going on in Kaduna. But as you've rightly said, we recently hosted a very important investment summit. But just a few days after, we, on our own again, we are coming with stories as if we do not even want investors to come. But to make viewers know exactly what is happening, I think there's a mix-up about this story. This whole story, there was no church that was attacked yesterday in Kaduna. What happened is that it's a community of Christians, so gunmen came into that community after church service, not in church. They didn't meet the people in church. The people had even dispersed and went home. They kidnapped 27 people. And as they were trying to get out of that community with them, someone who is a Christian was coming into that community unknowing what was happening. Then he was asking questions and the gunmen opened fire on him. I feel the commissioner on security didn't do enough search and went out to give such a story that is big today in Nigeria, but it's not true. There was no church that was attacked. The real community that were attacked and people were killed is in Kaura local government. We know that over 40-something people were killed last night. But this story that is all over Nigeria today is uncalled for, has no reason. But we've just realized that it's another pattern of our government to always come up with stories to scare people, to always come up with a story to whip sentiment, to always, because the way and manner he presented this story is that he was commiserating with ECWA, and ECWA never even knew anything about it. It took
so,
us
so why, all, why, almost why would you a, think that Samuel Arwan, the commissioner for security, would want to paint this picture as opposed to what you have said?
I don't know what he intends to gain. This is not the first time. There was a time he came out and said that bandits had went to a school in Ikara to kidnap students and security men how to repel them. And nothing like that ever happened. So I think it's already a business that some of us don't even understand. Because what I did yesterday was, when this story came out, I reach out to virtually every, because the system we have is that we have CAN at local governments, we have CAN at zonal levels, we have CAN in local communities. So once there's a problem in a community, they will pass it to the zonal level, and the zone will pass it to the local government, and the local government will send it to us in the state. Nobody could pin down this story. Since ECWA was involved, I called the ECWA headquarters. We keep talking with ECWA headquarters till 3 o'clock this afternoon before we understand that this story has nothing to do with the church building. And why I'm saying this, emphasizing it, is what exactly do they want to achieve by bringing such kind of story that a church was attacked? Caught me. There was no church that was attacked yesterday. The attack that happened in Kaduna State yesterday was actually kidnappers that kidnapped a community, not in the church. They were not during service. And as they were going, this man that you learned that was killed was actually a visitor coming into the community and just fall a victim and was gunned down, but not in the church. It has nothing to do with church. Yes, he is an ECWA member, but it was not in the church. So government must not be confusing us. I called the PPRO of the police yesterday night. I challenged him to verify this story. I called him again this afternoon. I challenged him, and he said, look, when he was actually the one who called me, and he realized that I didn't know. Then he knew that something was wrong with that story, because there's no way something will happen to a church and CAN is not aware, since we have a structure that we can confirm. Sam Aron should take us back to that church. Let us go and see that church. Let us know the church that was attacked. I think the honor is an apology to come out and tell people such kind of story when nothing actually happened. When I read on many pages of newspaper today, and I just realized how difficult it is when we have serious issues that they have failed to tackle, and they are bringing stories that do not even exist.
What are these serious issues that you think that the government of El Rufai has refused to tackle?
Are you aware that our children kidnapped on the 5th of July have not yet all come back? As at yesterday, 10 were released more, and we still have 11. Imagine children in a kidnap den for 82 days. Children, not adults, children.
What do you expect the government to do? Because they seem to be in between a rock and a hard place. And let's not forget that the governor had also publicly said that he was opposed to paying a ransom to free anybody that was abducted.
For those of us who know, sometimes when we hear it from you media, we just laugh at it. Because the reality is that he was the first governor who came out publicly and said, and I quote, on one of the national television, that he had to even follow gunmen to some part of Africa or some West African countries and pay them money. And he said that if there was any way people can advise him that he should do that to stop the killing, let us. So why suddenly this change of guard? But let me put it clear.
But of course, he's a human being. Isn't he allowed a change of heart? Probably he realized
of
he
course,
made a mistake.
He's a human being and
that he probably was
heart,
funding terrorism, and that's why he decided to take a step back.
At the time, he do not understand. But let me put it clear. We have never and will never require that our governor should negotiate with bandits, because we know if our government negotiates with bandits, it will be difficult, it will be bad for all of us. What we demand from government is one, she has sworn to protect lives and properties. If she do that, this banditry we are seeing, this killing we are seeing will not happen. I have ever said this and I want to repeat, that the Bethel Baptist High School is just 5 kilometers away from the NNPC Kaduna. If federal government on NNPC cannot be protected by government 15 to 20 to 30 kilometers away from that place, and this kind of evil can happen 5 kilometers to NNPC, it tells a lot about the security situation we are in. It tells a lot about the lip service we are giving to security. It tells a lot about the politics we bring into security. And we are not just honest. We are simply saying that if there is an incident, cross-check it and get the right fact. Don't just jump. Because today in Kaduna, we are being governed by media statements. Someone is just sitting down and pass media statement, and everybody just take it as if it is true. And we get confused. People sometimes call us and put us under fear. We land at the... No, yes, killing is going on in Kaduna. We are not disputing it. But this particular story, I want to repeat, they were misinformed, and they hastily went out to the press without cross-checking the facts about this story.
As much as, you know, we know that several insecurity issues have cropped up. In fact, for a time there, I actually, you know, thought that Kaduna had become a playing field for these bandits. But then CAN, in collaboration with other CSOs or Christian organizations, whether it be PFN or the enlarged forum where you have the Christians and the Muslims, all the stakeholders. Yes, we know that you have issues with how government is addressing the issue of insecurity, but has there been some form of a handshake across the table between you and the government? Has there been a fora where a conversation is being had with the government as to the way forward, as to how these issues can be best handled? Because it's one thing to criticize the government, it's one thing to scream at the government, but it's another to see how you can work with them to put an end to this insecurity. Has that been done?
So many groups are putting a lot of effort to help this government in addressing insecurity. But sadly, this government is a government that seems to be proud of herself. She knows everything. She can do everything. She understands everything. And every time she just go out in public and accuse people just like that. But the reality is that nothing is being done to tackle security. What they just do is simply to go always on media, rush to give information that are not correct, rush to instigate people against one another, rush to paint a picture that does not exist. But when there is a true crime, when there is a true security breach that is happening, they will turn their face away. And I think that's why some of us in Kaduna are so worried. What exactly, what kind of leadership are we getting? Are we being governed by media? Is it just a story of media? We really want to see Kaduna progress. People have made sacrifice and are still making tremendous sacrifice to make sure that things work and work good for Kaduna. But the truth is that we are disappointed. What we thought was good had turned out to be something else. This particular story, I want to insist, was wrongly presented. It is not right. There was no event like that. The fact that the confusion was because they mixed up the story with other local government. But when we followed carefully and realized that story is not like that, and we appeal to them to please correct this story so that they will not continue to paint the entire people in bad light and put the Christian leaders on tension that there was an attack on church. And then as well, when we called them for an attack, what did they do? Why are they bringing an issue of an attack when there was nothing? Why did they rush to call that they are sympathizing with ECOWA, that they show concern with ECOWA? Well, ECOWA did not even know what happened.
I struggle. I really sincerely struggle to with the fact that the El Rufai government would in one breath and spend so much money to try to get people to come to invest in Kaduna State. And then in another breath, turn away or turn its attention away from the insecurity in the country. I find that very hard to believe. Because if I want people to invest in my business or in my state, I would make sure that it's a safe haven for people to come and invest, because nobody wants to invest in a place that's not a safe haven. So I'm really struggling to understand how this government, according to you, is not paying attention to insecurity. They're more of a media government, according to you. But then they threw this big event asking people to come to the estate and invest. It's a bit ridiculous to break down.
Question, let me just take you 4 weeks back. The government of Kaduna State came out publicly and said she was going to lock down or shut down all schools because the military were going to go into an exercise to get rid of bandits all over Kaduna. Schools were shut down, but within that period, the attackers went to NDA, attacked, killed, and even kidnapped a military man. And kidnapping just continued in the state. When we've not even have solution to that, they quickly again say that schools should reopen. And still, kidnapping and killings are going on in Kaduna State. That's why some of us who have been following the events realize that this whole thing is just a political gimmick. We've not really sit down to address the issues that are going on. We have not really sit down to look at this insecurity and address them. The fact of all is that those who openly come out in Kaduna to shout that something is wrong, people are not secured, I call names. But the reality is that people have been killed. Last night, I just told you 40-something people in Kaura local government were killed in Kaduna State. What steps have government taken to secure these people? But every day on newspaper, every day on the television, we see a lot of things that gives a picture as all is well, but all is not well. As a Bible student, I'm familiar with this. During Prophet Jeremiah, people will come out and say, it is well, when the reality is that all is not well. Kaduna is really, really, really in a mess. But since we have chosen to listen to governance by media, we will continue to die, but watch fantastic stories on television.
Well, it's a bit confusing, but I hope that everybody stays safe, including you, and hopefully something changes and things take a different turn. Reverend Joseph Hayab is the CAN chairman for Kaduna State. Thank you very much for speaking with us. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me too.
All right. Well, I want to thank you all for staying with us and being part of the great conversations we've had tonight. I'll be back tomorrow, same time, on Plus TV Africa. I'm Mary Anacol, and have a good evening.